privilege to work with folks at end of life, as well as those who are left behind after beloveds have passed. And I create and sing in unique ceremonies, both living and after death memorials, and then support the bereaved afterwards. And the beauty of being able to sing is how much it serves the people that are there in helping them connect to their hearts and their spirits and their grief, as well as to one another. This is one of my favorites that I really love to incorporate into ceremony, and it's an African traditional poem that Isaye Barnwell of Sweet Honey and the Rock set to music. And it is called Breaths. Listen more often to things than to beings. Listen more often to things than to beings. 'Tis the ancestor's breath when the fire's voice is heard. 'Tis the ancestor's breath in the voice of the water. Those who have died have never, never left. The dead are not under the earth. They are in the rustling trees. They are in the groaning woods. They are in the crying grass. They are in the moaning rocks. The dead are not under the earth. So listen more often to things than to beings. Listen more often to things than to beings. 'Tis the ancestor's breath when the fire's voice is heard. 'Tis the ancestor's breath in the voice of the water. Those who have died have never, never left. The dead have a pact with the living. They are in the mother's breast. They are in the wailing child. They are with us in the home. They are with us in this crowd. The dead have a pact with the living. So listen more often to things than to beings. Listen more often to things than to beings. 'Tis the ancestor's breath when the fire's voice is heard. 'Tis the ancestor's breath in the voice of the water.